Ahead on NFL Turning Point.
We're here now, but are you satisfied?
The Seahawks come back in Washington. Ray Lewis wired in his final home game. And Aaron Rodgers gets ready for the Niners. Hello once again, I'm Dan Patrick, and welcome to NFL Turning Point. The brilliant debut of three rookie quarterbacks, Andrew Luck, Robert Griffin III, and Russell Wilson, was one of the biggest stories of the 2012 season. And with Wilson and RG3 facing off on Wild Card Weekend, at least one of them would be playing in the second round.
Hey, it's over for
him. It's going to be a
long day.
Demolition time.
Long time.
Running through everything.
Everything. Running through everything.
Welcome to FedEx Field. It ends here for one of these two teams.
For us, ain't nothing different. We've been doing this all year long. It's our time. It's our moment. It's our destiny. Our time, ain't nothing they can do about it.
The real key for Washington is how healthy is that knee for RG3. He says it's better this week than it was last week.
We're here now, but we ain't satisfied. Our journey continues, man. Let's go get 8 in a row, man. Let's dominate these boys. It's personal today. It's personal today.
We ain't doing too much, we're doing us, though. That's enough to win, I promise.
Gotcha. All right?
The hopes of the Redskins rested on the hobbled right knee of quarterback Robert Griffin. But early against the Seahawks, it was a weight he did not have to bear alone.
Here in the early going, at least, doing a nice job mixing it up offensively and not having RG3 have to do much at all.
See how wide that back is?
Yeah.
You know right now it's tough.
All right.
Okay, it's the only play they got, right? Last 8 games, right?
It's a pitch right, Alfred Morris looking for room. Across the 20 to the 15. One man to beat. Inside the 5, down to the 2-yard line.
On their first drive of the game, the Redskins outmuscled one of the most physical defenses in the league.
The Redskins are trying to cram it right down the Seahawks' throat in the first possession.
Keep your head on soon, boy.
Robert takes the snap, looking up the middle. Oh, touchdown! Evan Royster, the touchdown catch, and the Redskins draw first blood.
They're gonna kick our ass every series if you don't man up. You gotta man up, all right? Outside run, get outside. Inside run, stay inside. They ain't ran inside yet, all right? Do not get blocked.
Half of the league's best rushing backfield was clicking. The other half, hesitating.
There was a nice lane inside that block by Logan Paulson, and we've seen enough of him throughout this season that when healthy, he would have taken that and picked up a nice chunk of yardage.
On the Redskins' second drive, the thin ice on which Griffin tread appeared to crack.
First and goal at the 4-yard line. Play action, bootleg to the right. RG3 rolling, pumps, fires, caught, and dropped. Garcon had it.
And now Griffin is really slow back to the huddle.
I wish he hadn't ran it, because he stopped his body, and he had to stop abruptly. He put a lot of pressure on that leg, and you see it kind of folded under it.
He is limping severely now back to the huddle.
That sideline's got to be awfully concerned with what they're seeing body language-wise out of Griffin.
Be careful, boy.
Third and goal. Robert looking,
healthy is that knee?
I talked to Robert, and Robert said to me, he said, Coach, there's a difference between injured and being hurt. And I said, I guarantee I'm hurting right now. Give me a chance to win this football game because I guarantee I'm not injured.
Mike asked me if I was okay. I said yes. I'm the quarterback of this team. My job is to be out there if I can play. I don't feel like me being out there hurt the team in any way. I'm the best option for this team, and that's why I'm the starter.
Hey, sure you're all right, bro?
Yeah, I'm gonna be safe.
You tweaked it?
Huh?
You tweaked it when you were trying to back up?
Yeah, I seen that. My foot kind of went. So
that kind of shocked you a little bit?
Seahawks trying to find a little life here on offense and take this crowd out of the game a little bit.
Yeah, they've got a lot of work to do offensively. Only 9 yards so far in that first quarter.
To jumpstart a stagnant offense, the Seahawks turned to a scheme they installed because of the Redskins.
Showing a little bit of what a healthy RG3 can do as they have that read option. Pete Carroll saw what Washington was doing with RG3. They implemented some of it. It's been very successful for them.
And when the read option wasn't executed perfectly, it still worked. With the defense keying on the two primary playmakers in Seattle's backfield, fullback Michael Robinson was left uncovered and untouched.
It's Robinson all by himself. He steps into the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks.
Yes,
when you run the ball the way we do, when you got to quarterback who can run the ball, when you have a running back like Marshawn in the backfield, anytime you get full flow, guys are going to step up. And I just kind of slipped into the flat, and Russell did a great job getting the ball to me.
Yeah. All right, now, we got to make sure we come out and get the ball. We got to come out there and get the ball. We got to blow up on defense down, all right?
RG3 out of the shotgun, rides inside, play fake. Now he's going to look, now he's going to let it fly downfield. Like the deep pass, Garcon is down here. And so is Earl, who picks it off at the 25.
Hey, they don't just throw that thing up. They don't just throw that thing up. Let's go, let's go.
RG3 doesn't realize he had a much open receiver coming across the football field that he could have went to in Josh Morgan, but he went up top. Earl Thomas came over there from his Pro Bowl safety spot and makes the interception.
Earlier in the game, the Seahawks secondary, preoccupied with possible comeback routes, nearly let the Redskins score a third touchdown.
That's the only way we're going to let them back in the game is if we get the ball thrown over our head. All right, stay on top. Stay on top.
Hey, all right, good
on top.
On the interception, Earl Thomas, the deepest man on the field for Seattle, stayed on top and made the play.
Hey, gonna win this, huh? They don't want no pieces of you. He thought we was them other defenses. He thought he could just throw it up and we wasn't gonna pick it. Come on.
And the Seahawks draw to within a point. Looked grim early in this game when the Seahawks fell behind 14-0. But they have scrapped their way back and owned the second quarter.
Coming up, are the Packers ready for their rematch with the Niners? But up next, the dramatic finish in Washington.
Does he pile into the end zone? He does! Touchdown, Seahawks! So the Seahawks have scored on their last three possessions, two field goals and a touchdown, 13 unanswered points to bring them within a point.
Washington's rookie quarterbacks were on the bench for most of the second half, watching Seattle's rookie quarterback. And they got to see what all the fuss was about. On two good legs, Russell Wilson did a little bit of everything.
Cuts back to the right side, picks up a blocker, it's his quarterback, turns upfield across the 40, down the near sidelines, knocked out of bounds.
Number three got gone, didn't he? The quarterback.
Oh, yeah.
His arm strength was on display on this comeback route from the far hash, a signature throw that separates college and pro passers. The Redskins played an eight-man front, and Wilson powered the ball to Golden Tate in the requisite one-on-one matchup on the outside.
He got enough RPMs on the football, kept it to the outside, so Golden take and go up and make that catch.
Despite moving the ball consistently, Seattle was having a tough time crossing the goal line.
The ball came out, and the Redskins recover on the one-yard line. Oh, my word. Marshawn Lynch coughs it up.
The game was back in the hands of the Seahawks' physical defense, who fought for every inch of turf. And adjusted their game plan to account for the Redskins' hobbled hero.
And RG3 gets hit. He gets hit just shy of the goal line.
Defenders that would normally be concerned with RG3's read option were instead able to drop more quickly into coverage.
Nobody to throw to, and Branch gets credit for the sack of RG3.
After we saw, you know, what he was doing and how he could move, then, you know, I tried to encourage the guys to not be worried about him breaking contain and running like crazy, that it was more like a normal quarterback back there, and we could keep our pressure in our rushes and not be so concerned about trying to just keep him in the pocket.
When Griffin wanted to hit the home run, Richard Sherman and his fellow defensive backs struck him out. On Bruce Irvin's sack, Sherman passed off the post route to his inside help and fell back to cover the over route.
He's looking, he's going to go down. Bruce Irvin gets him all the way back to the 10-yard line.
Hey, that over, I knew my boys had me.
Oh, yeah,
they picked him back up.
The post right there?
Yep. Hey, that's called trust. That's called trust. That's called trust. You picked that damn post up, I had the over. Hey, that's trust. You my dog. You my dog. I love y'all. I love y'all. They can't mess with us. We too good. Hey, we too good.
Defensively, you know, you sometimes have to pick your offense up, and, you know, we needed to make, I think, one more play. When the score was 14-13, we weren't able to get off the field.
Third and 10 from their own 46. He's got time.
On the drive that turned the game, Wilson was at his best.
Zach Miller, the catch, and he's got a first down in the Redskin territory.
The big play when Russell scoots out and dumps it to him was just a marvelous job of Russell doing his thing.
On third and 10, Wilson held his cadence to point out the blitzing safety to rookie running back Robert Turbin. With Turbin's block secured, Wilson had time to find the leaking Zach Miller.
Well, Zach Miller came up huge tonight. The check down on third down, I was going through my whole entire progression, and he came out, he was my last read, and he was there for me, and he did a great job of making that big time catch and continuing on for a big first down.
Trailing by one with less than 8 minutes to play, Seattle turned to Marshawn Lynch, and Lynch delivered a turning point.
Third down and 5 from the 27. Here comes the inside handoff to Lynch. He breaks another tackle. He's down inside the 10, down to the 5. Russell's still blocking. Does he pile into the end zone? He does! Touchdown, Seahawks!
Wait, how would you grade Russell's downfield blocking?
He did pretty well, you know. He did okay. He's been doing that. You guys haven't even noticed it. This is about the fourth or fifth time he's made some pretty cool plays.
Russell Wilson, once again, is not just a spectator.
Great job by the quarterback. Just his awareness, his football IQ, to figure that Marshawn was coming back.
The play featured a pancake block by Miller and two cutbacks by Lynch. The first was a result of a hard slant by the defensive end. The second made D'Angelo Hall look like a cornerback trying to tackle a beast.
The run that Marshawn makes was a great run, great finish. And just, it's really, that's what he does for us and what he has done all year long. It was cool that he did it to give us the chance to separate and get the win.
I'm gonna play.
That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, I need you, Sean. I got you.
Yeah,
I need
baby.
You, Sean. I promise you, I got you. I ain't gonna lie, bro. I need you. Yep.
Let's go, baby. Let's go get it. Come on.
One time. Come on, baby.
Ready, Sean?
Robert could not get up.
His leg just gave away on him.
And everybody concerned about Robert Griffin III.
The quarterback fumbled it. He never caught the ball. His knee went out on him.
We actually got a chance to sit at the dinner table and experience success, and it was a good meal. But now we want to go back and get dessert, and we'll be ready to get dessert next year.
The way this team played on the road in such a hostile environment and came back from 14 points down, just an amazing performance.
What's going to do, boy?
I'm going to punch you in your
ass. Hey, do it then, boy.
Griffin want to talk to you real quick.
Huh?
Robert Griffin want to talk to you real quick.
You mad, bro?
I'm about to talk. He want to talk to me.
Hey,
great to see you, boy.
Hey, y'all go win this thing, all right?
Yep, you know it, boy. You've been having a hell of a year. I'm proud of you, boy.
Thank you, man.
Hey.
I'll be watching. Y'all go do that thing, all right?
Appreciate it. Get that thing healthy.
Got it.
Can you win the game in the first quarter?
No!
Can you win the game in the second quarter?
No!
Can you win the game in the third quarter?
No!
Can you win the game in the fourth quarter?
Yeah!
I've been waiting for a long time to say that.
Still to come, Ray Lewis's last dance in Baltimore. But up next, the Packers tune up for a visit to the Bay Area.
Touchdown, John Coates, and the Packers are on their way to San Francisco.
Welcome back to NFL Turning Point, brought to you by Chevrolet. 17 weeks ago, Alex Smith and the 49ers opened up the regular season with an impressive victory in Green Bay. Things have changed since then, but Aaron Rodgers and the Packers look as formidable as ever heading into the rematch.
The Packers were facing Adrian Peterson for the third time in 6 weeks. But it would be the first time this season they saw an offense largely based on the read option.
You just don't know.
Don't know what's coming.
Okay.
Don't know what's coming.
Okay.
Okay, about to see
y'all.
It's cold out here. I'm about to warm up.
Joe Webb, starting in place of the injured Christian Ponder, provided a glimpse of what the Packers will see against 49ers quarterback Colin Kaepernick.
And the handoff, no. Joe Webb takes it, fakes left. Now he's going to sprint to the right. Shakes a tackle at the 40, bumps out to the right, and he walks into Packers territory.
Keep it, Joe. You don't want to see him out there.
That's the dimension that he brings to the party. He appeared to be encased in defenders in the backfield, able to squirm loose.
Joe presents another element. We've played some zone read guys this year, and it can be tough on defense. So as a defense player, we know what it is to try to get down an athletic quarterback.
And the hand fake handoff. Webb on the roll. Right side gets a block from Rudolph.
Rudolph blocking on A.J. Hawk. And that's something they can put in for Joe Webb. They had a week to get ready. Packers found out like an hour before the game.
Set the edge, okay? Stay low. Stay low.
This guy, I'm telling you, you never know when he's down. We're swimming and looping around him. That's creating that lane for him right there.
They're going to try to run AP. And then change that. No. And he is not a pocket passer.
In week one against San Francisco, Green Bay faced a pure pocket passer in Alex Smith for all but one play.
Kaepernick's in the game. Takes the shotgun snap. He's going to run up the middle. Kaepernick all the way into Green Bay territory.
And that time it was the Packers rushing three, dropping eight, and they dropped. So Kaepernick took full advantage.
Under a blitz, Webb steps up, does what he does best, running.
Joe had some good runs early that kept some drives going, but eventually we're able to get ahead and make them have to do some more passing, and we did a good job against that.
Unlike Kaepernick, Webb has yet to show the ability to be a dual threat in the passing game.
Joe
Webb overthrew him by a good 5 yards.
With a different quarterback, that might have been problems.
Interesting to see how the Packers defense is adapting with Joe Webb, and they're doing kind of a delay rush where defensive linemen kind of sit up, wait for Joe to see what he's doing. Once they realize it's a pass, they try to get just enough pressure to get those balls to fly high.
I got him. I'm like, oh, I can throw him and go.
I know.
Because I got him in the control.
Go, but it's like, it's not worth it, bro.
It ain't. So I understand that. I'm like, man, this one, man. Check, rip.
Here's the snap at first down, give to Peterson. He slips and falls, gets up, now squirts to his right. He's on the run, got a first down. How did he make this happen?
Adrian Peterson averaged over 200 rushing yards in two games versus the Packers. But neither of those contests featured converted safety Charles Woodson, who was returning after a two-month absence.
Charles Woodson cheats to the line of scrimmage, comes on a blitz. Here comes Charles Woodson.
Charles Woodson knifing in from his safety spot.
They had Jarius Wright assigned to block him, and Charles Woodson just knifed inside that block.
You're hitting the hell out of that jack now. Just be ready. They're going to have every extra hat in Green Bay in there. So let's get used to it.
It's not going
to
work.
I know it won't.
You don't think they want 21 to tackle, probably?
I'm assuming that they want him to stay at the safety spot. That's what it looked like to me in that series. Then again, they might have just it up, though, too.
That's true.
Similar to Hall of Famer Rod Woodson, number 21 was an all-pro cornerback who switched to safety before this season. In his first start at the new position, Woodson failed to contain Frank Gore on the game-clinching touchdown.
Daniel Kilgore completely sealed off, and he took the legs of Charles Woodson.
That was a sad-looking play.
Mm-hmm.
Based off week one, I like to run the ball. Frank Gore is an outstanding athlete, and he's on my fantasy team. That's okay. We were expecting to be a tough, hard-fought match, similar to week one.
Gibbons to Peterson around the right end, following the blocking, breaks through. He's across the 45, run down by Charles Woodson.
Woodson is a great player. Saved a touchdown by tapping to me, because that was definitely one to the distance. He's a difference maker.
That was a Woodson tackle, big time.
Yeah.
Physical.
Good to see him back. Boy, is it good
to see him back. One-on-one with Adrian Peterson, put him on the ground.
Wood just brings a whole different dimension.
He does.
He just brings a whole different dimension.
Yeah.
Got aggressive balls to the wall.
Another new wrinkle for Green Bay is a rejuvenated running game.
They give to Cone up the middle, slips by defenders for the head, touchdown!
In week one, Packers running back Cedric Benson had 9 carries for 18 yards.
Cedric was our main back. Well, I don't think we had our identity at that point. You know, we were trying a lot of different things.
Since week 9, the Packers have averaged over 30 rushing attempts a game.
We got him. Maybe not.
Behind the recently unemployed Ryan Grant, fullback John Kuhn.
Kuhn at the 5, to the end zone, for the touchdown!
And Duwan Harris, who was selling used cars only a few months ago.
Duwan Harris making a name for himself this late season. The Packers have finally said goodnight to all day and are on their way to the NFC Divisional Playoffs in San Francisco.
I can let you know here, but join MVP. Win a championship again now.
A lot has changed since week one, but you can tell we'll have to come out here, and similar to this team we played the last 2 weeks, we're going to have to stop the run and get after the quarterback. We did a good job of that tonight. We took a step in the right direction, so hopefully that carries over into this next week.
Coming up later, how the Texans held off the Bengals, but when we return...
There's only one man left to introduce.
Ray Lewis wired one last time in Baltimore.
The last dance begins in Baltimore.
Welcome back to NFL Turning Point, presented by Chevrolet. There was no shortage of storylines and subplots heading into the Colts-Ravens AFC wildcard game. But after 17 years in Baltimore, it was only fitting that Ray Lewis take center stage one more time.
The start of the playoffs always marks the special time of the year. But this time around, the beginning of the playoffs also marks the beginning of the end for Ray Lewis. The Ravens' future Hall of Fame linebacker will retire following this postseason, and that makes this his final home game as a Baltimore Raven.
You
You're going to enjoy this.
We will.
Enjoy this.
We will.
These guys are going to play for you. It's going to be an exciting experience.
We're going all in. We all in.
How you doing?
Oh,
good.
My God.
I love you, man.
How you doing, man?
I'm good.
I love you so much.
You, man. Yes, sir.
Oh, I love you so
yes,
much.
Yes, sir. Love you too, man.
Thank you so much.
Glad to be here for you.
Oh, thank you so much.
Love it, man. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh,
good to
boy.
See you.
Oh,
go
boy.
Get it, man. Please.
Oh, you're going right? to make me clown today.
Oh, yeah.
don't make me get emotional, Evie. Don't make me get emotional, Evie. Don't make me get emotional.
Right.
Oh, my God. Let's go.
I got all the tears out of my eyes. Let's go.
Yeah.
Despite missing 10 weeks with a torn triceps, Ray Lewis was his old self. Baltimore's defense was once again whole.
Get off the damn field!
I mean, it's definitely great. You know, I think it was our first time that, you know, having Terrell Suggs and myself and Ed Reed and Ray Lewis out there all together. So we're all healthy, and we had a great game today, and hopefully we continue to get better.
With their four best defenders on the field, the Ravens were able to blitz Andrew Luck from everywhere with everyone.
Got the blitz out the middle. Luck pops once. He's hit. Ball is loose at the 42-yard line. And the Ravens recover it.
I'm looking at them. I say, boy, these boys nervous. They in the Thunderdome now.
And he took a shot here.
Luck only completed 5 passes for 56 yards when Baltimore sent 5 or more rushers.
Everybody on this defensive side can be a blitzer. Who's going to blitz? Corey Graham comes off the slot, and what makes it so difficult, they look at your formation and determine, all right, I'll blitz this time and you cover, and they switch up.
You drop it. You drop it. True.
Luck takes a snap. The pressure runs up the middle, and he'll be drilled as Terrell Suggs knocks him down.
Let's go! Let's go!
You get that boy, you going out? Anytime you have the ball, we're going to switch with you.
Okay.
Go off the edge, we come and we
got it. Same route. Let's go. Pick 6 right here.
Andrew Luck on first down, wants to throw off play action, steps up, pass deflected at the line, intercepted by Ray Lewis! $71,000.
I never lived that one down. I'm going to put that one on the brace because I tried to pull my arm up, but the brace wouldn't come out.
Hey.
Hey.
The guy in your way catching
hey.
That ball.
Yeah, I got dirt.
Darn it.
You
should have basketed that thing.
I tried to. Look, as soon as I tried to basket it.
I thought you were going to get it when you died.
You know?
I hope you don't get it.
That was pretty bad.
I would have scored too, huh?
Oh, yeah. It was 6 for sure.
God darn it.
I was a lead blocker too.
The Lord must be new. I wasn't going to be right.
Because you know you're going to take it right back.
I was going to wiggle.
Baltimore's offense also missed its share of scoring opportunities, twice coming up empty in the red zone.
Flacco under center. Draw play. Delayed handoff. Ray Rice looking for an opening. Can't find one. Ball comes loose.
Oh!
The Colts get the ball, the first turnover of the day.
Corey Redding caused the fumble.
Freeman recovered it for the Colts.
Going the wrong way, my bad.
Yeah, stop all the dance, let's go.
If Ogo score right here, we get the ball up the half. We open it wide open.
Let's go. Hey, screen and draw on the first play.
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Ray Rice made up for the red zone fumble with his longest reception of the season.
Flacco wants to throw a screen. Colts have it red, but he still completes it twice.
the running back, and I had to let him go, and he just done
the Ray Rice was bumping Robert Mathis at the beginning of that play, and then Flacco was able to get it to him, and Ray Rice does what he can do. He's talented.
It was actually a screen. They actually played it. Me and Joseph ended up finding each other, looking at each other eye in eye.
Great job by Joe Flacco because they had it covered, and Ray checked down out of the screen and then actually went downfield and caught the pass. That's a great adjustment, and Joe's seeing it too.
Great job running. Outstanding job blocking down the football field by Torrey Smith.
And the Ravens will have it first and goal with 55 seconds left in the half.
That's what you do. All we got to do is get it in your hand.
Give us to the up back.
Let's go!
Good job, 4-4. Good
job. Brings our score at halftime to Ravens 10, Colts 6.
Coming up, the Ravens put the game in a pair of sure hands.
Lobs the ball, end zone, Bolden, pass it, touchdown, Ravens!
Let's go! Let's go!
Hey. Though Ray Lewis couldn't even raise his right arm to buckle his chin strap, he continued to carry a defense and an entire city with his effort.
Take three deep breaths and let's go. Ray, take three deep breaths and let's go.
It's always so funny to hear people say, well, he's not the same as he was 10 years ago, you know? Who is, you know? But he's found different ways to play the game. He's still a great football player.
Ray Lewis came back after a 10-week absence with a tricep injury and once again turned back the clock with a performance like no 17-year veteran has ever turned in.
I feel great, man. You know what I'm saying?
We're flying around out there.
Let's beat that quarterback up. Let's beat his ass up.
Despite the presence of premier pass rushers Robert Mathis and Dwight Freeney, the Colts failed to fluster Joe Flacco in the second half.
Pocket collapses. He's on the run. Throws complete. Pitta, 10, 5, Pitta, touchdown! Dennis Pitta! And the Ravens have their second touchdown of the day! Yeah!
Had him wrapped up. He got it out.
The inability of Indianapolis to get Flacco on the ground allowed the Ravens to alter their offensive approach. And their decision to target Anquan Boldin downfield became the game's turning point.
In the second half, we definitely had a little emphasis on kind of stretching the field a little bit, and that started with Anquan.
Held without a catch in the first half, Boldin had five in the second.
You know, I went up to him before the game and told him I feel like 200 yards today. I don't know if he thought I was joking, but, you know, he gave me a shot in the second half.
Boldin's franchise playoff record, 145 receiving yards, broke the game open.
Lobs the ball, end zone, Boldin.
Just a good job, Anquan, of, you know, winning the route and going up and making a nice catch. Zivikowski rotated back late to the single high. Bethea came down and covered Dennis one-on-one. Anquan was left one-on-one on the corner route. He got outside of the guy and was able to put his left foot in the ground and go towards the back of the end zone, so I knew I had a shot at him. I probably put a little bit too much air on it just because I threw it, like, as he was coming out of his break, and I wanted him to be able to find the ball. If I threw it a little firmer towards the back of the end zone, it probably would have been an easier catch.
Bro, the DB arm was in there.
That's a man.
That is a backbreaker right there. That's not over. But boy, the Colts have to, they can't make mistakes at all now.
We ain't give up no touchdown today.
Now we hunt.
Now we hunt.
Now we hunt.
Hey, it's like just a game now. Let's go.
We play our best.
Got to score. See, and that's pressure because the clock running. You know what I'm saying? Then this young boy ain't ready for that yet. You know?
I mean, he didn't ask to come back victory.
Yeah. Not on this defense.
Fittingly, the defense triggered their leader's celebratory send-off.
Ravens looking for a knockout punch. Blocked from the gun. Throws quickly. It's broken up and intercepted. Kerry Williams.
And the Ravens defense just locked up this wild card game. It was fourth and short, so they played it aggressively, played for the short throw. Corey Graham stepped in front, deflected it. That's Williams right. was there as well. What a double effort by these two corners of the Ravens.
A day that starts with a dance and ends with celebration on a 24-9 Ravens victory over the Colts.
They ain't getting the end zone. They ain't getting the end zone.
Now the Ravens future Hall of Famer standing on the sideline saluting his fans who have risen as one in a standing ovation for number 52. No man before him ever wore that Ravens uniform. No man after him will ever wear that Ravens uniform.
Man, I love you, bro, for life. Love you, man. Honor to be by your side, bro.
Thank you so much.
Honor, bro.
I told you I had you, boy. We got two more. That's one.
I might have you take a bow. I might put you on victory. Be the back guy.
Okay, I'll go get my helmet. Yeah, let's do that.
You know, when John came to me and said, you know, that they wanted me to do that last play, the funny part about it, he never knew this. I've always wanted to do that play, you know, in the league. Yeah, I just never was bold enough to go to a coordinator and say, Coach, let me go do that last play.
Don't tackle the quarterback, all right?
I won't.
We're on offense, baby.
I won't.
Today was about me giving everything I got. I just saw how many people were still in the stand.
71,349 Ravens fans all wanting to savor a last moment with Ray Lewis.
For me to take that last lap, I just think it was so appropriate. Everything I did to get back was for my city. I knew how it started, but I never knew how it was going to end here in Baltimore. For it to go the way it went today, I wouldn't change nothing.
When we return, a strong performance from Arian Foster propels Houston to the second round.
Dives in! Touchdown, Houston!
Welcome back to NFL Turning Point, brought to you by Chevrolet. After losing three of their final four games, the Texans found themselves hosting the Bengals in the opening round of the playoffs for the second straight year. And for the second straight year, the Bengals proved to be just what the Texans needed.
After a rough stretch run of the regular season, the Texans begin again. But a second straight year, Houston is in the playoffs. And to move on, the Texans will have to stop a hot team and get themselves reignited.
For Bengals fans, the biggest question on Saturday wasn't why they lost. It was why didn't A.J. Green get the ball in the first half? The answer was in the game plan. Throw early and often to tight end Jermaine Gresham.
Win the next play. Hear me? Just win the next play. Don't worry about the rest of it. Because here's the thing. You're going to have to win a ball game with understand me? Go do it.
Gresham's size and speed were perceived as a viable option against Houston's smaller defensive backs.
One of the designs of the play, we were trying to get Jermaine involved early, trying to get some of these other guys going. Such a big guy that you put him on linebackers and even the, you know, their dime guy, we felt like with his big body, you can create a little bit of space and do things like that.
Hey, you're good.
I'm not good.
Houston dominated the Bengals in every statistical category but one. The score.
It was going so well, but the man who could ill afford to make a big mistake made a huge one.
And it's here, separate good from great. This way you go from good to great, like this.
With Houston's air attack grounded, the Texans leaned heavily on the legs of Arian Foster. His ability to make tacklers miss in the second level was a key factor to the Texans nearly doubling the Bengals' time of possession.
Mal Lugan did not even get a hand on him. In flag football, he went.
That's all they're doing is free releasing him and putting the linebackers on him. The linebackers got to just go ahead and go get his ass.
Texans have the ball at the 1 yard line of Cincinnati, second and goal. Arian dives in, touchdown Houston.
The Bengals trail by 9, it feels like 90.
Well, I think we control the line of scrimmage, and anytime we do that, it's going to be tough to beat us because we eat up clock, and our offense is predicated off of the run.
Immediately following Foster's touchdown, the Bengals finally look to involve their own offensive star. After having 0 targets in the first half, Green was targeted 11 times, catching 5 balls for 80 yards.
To stretch the field to A.J. Green.
I was like, they might cloud it, but I don't care. I'm getting the ball.
Just keep being decisive.
Houston's defense was disruptive throughout the game, making it hard for Dalton and Green to find a rhythm.
Dalton throws downfield, picked off Jonathan Joseph to his right, 35, 30, and down at the 27-yard line.
I don't know why A.J. Green's not looking. He's got to be aware. A.J. Green's got to see this football. The ball was on top of him because Dalton, the anticipated blitz, it had to come out, but Green's got to see it.
Despite Houston's dominance, Cincinnati found itself within striking distance late in the fourth quarter. All they needed was a turning point.
Get away, Jay!
2 minutes and 57 seconds left. Cincinnati trails 19-13. Dalton back to throw. The pocket closes, and he's going to air it out for A.J. Green in the end zone. Overthrown and incomplete. He was open, and Andy did not deliver.
He put a little more air under that football. That thing could have been there. It's a deep ball accuracy issue once again.
We had a double move on. AJ ran a good route. And just threw it a little bit too far. It's a play that if we would make it, I mean, obviously the game's a whole lot different.
Danielle Manning, to me, was late. The safety getting over to help. He caught him flat-footed. He's open. You know it's a tight window, but that's a throw you got to make.
Bengals' offense just didn't show up with any kind of consistency today. Defensively, heroic effort.
This game
always a game of interest, and you know, that's something we need to work on. I feel like our deep ball wasn't consistent enough, both on my part and his part. I feel like something we need to work on coming in offseason.
The Texans get the job done and move on to take on the Patriots next week. A hard-fought playoff game at Reliance Stadium. Nobody said it was going to be easy, and it certainly wasn't.
Okay, I'm so proud of how you hung in there and came through this thing. We all know where we're at, okay? We're battle-tested. Let's get our ready to go again. I'm so proud of you. Congratulations. I'd give you a ball, but I think there's a bigger one that we'd all like that.
Thanks for being with us on this special postseason edition of NFL Turning Point. Be sure to join us again next week for comprehensive coverage of all the action from the divisional round of the playoffs.
Hey, baby.
I want to say you had a great career, man.
Thank you so much.
Pretty much working your games. Keep it going, man.
Coach, come get me. They got wolves out here. They got boogie monsters.
Hey, bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Here we go.